Hey everyone, Shaw from Teaching 2 and 3-year-olds. In a recent video, I talked about how I expose my 2 and 3-year-olds to letters. And today I want to talk about numbers. We're always exposing the children to different numbers throughout our classroom. We're always working on counting skills, especially at circle time. There are so many ways that you can do it in hands-on, playful ways. So today, I thought I would show you some of my favorites. First of all, foam numbers. Just like foam letters, I love foam numbers. And we have actually used these mostly in our sensory bin. In fact, one of the easiest ways to do foam numbers is to fill your sensory bin, well, not fill it to the top, but just kind of slightly fill your sensory bin up with a little bit of water, just enough to cover the numbers. And then you can provide scoops, you could provide little tongs, bug tongs, whatever, and bowls, so they can pull the numbers out and then they can put them into a little bin. We also have used these with rice in the sensory bin. You can also use these, I mean, you can use them on your light table, you can use them at Play-Doh, and the same can go with, you might have seen these little foam number fit togethers. You just place them inside like this. This is a fun table activity. And magnetic numbers are always fun. And we use these. I have a big whiteboard, magnetic whiteboard that we keep up. It's for circle time, but I also have it up during centers time. So the children like to put the numbers on there. I also love to find stencils that have numbers. And you can see this is an example. This is an alphabet stamp stencil, but it also has numbers at the bottom. Another place where you can do counting is at the table activity area. So this doesn't look like a counting activity, but when the children are putting the little checkers into, they're dropping them in, I've heard them counting. And then they'll count how many slots there are. So a lot of counting can take place even where there aren't any numbers. These sandpaper numbers are nice. The children can take each one and they can trace them with their fingers. And of course, puzzles are a great place to work on number recognition and counting skills. I mean, we've got so many floor puzzles. These are great for like ages 3, 4, and 5. They enjoy doing these during small groups, but there are lots of puzzles that we put at our table activity area, like these. These are, this is a magnetic puzzle, and these are cars going up to 10. And then there's a lot of toys like this that they progress from 1, like this one goes to 5. But what I also love about this type of activity is that it also works on color skills too. So you're doing both. Our younger children usually take these and first match them by color. Then they start noticing the numbers on here and they'll count as they're putting them on there. And there's a lot of stacking activities too. These have the numbers on the bottom. I have heard them count as they nest the cups. And then Barrel of Monkeys, of course. This is an old classic. And these strip puzzles are nice. This particular one was from Lakeshore a while ago. But you put the strips in numerical order, and when you do so, it makes a picture. And then something like this, you would think, okay, this is fine motor. We do this quite a bit. Well, we have pom-poms and we have an ice cube tray. But you could take it one step further and you can count the pom-poms as you put them into the tray. Dramatic play is another great area to work on counting skills. For example, this is just one of many examples, but we have a birthday cake. And as you probably know, young children love to talk about birthdays and how old they are. And so when they're putting the candles on the cake, they're always counting. I'm 3, so they're putting 3 candles on it. But a lot of the different activities that we have at Dramatic Play can include counting. We have cash registers that we use so much. In fact, when we had an ice cream store in our Dramatic Play area a few months ago, the children were noticing the numbers on the cash register. And then, of course, they were looking at the numbers that were on the dollar bills. And they're looking at how many scoops do you want to put on your ice cream cone, or how many cherries do you want to put on your ice cream. These are all excellent ways to work on number recognition and counting skills through play. And I see it all morning long happening in all of our centers during our classroom day. Circle time offers a lot of opportunities for counting recognition. Even with our youngest children, we do a lot of counting while we're singing. For example, this is our Five Little Speckled Frogs prop, and this is in my song and rhymes packet. I'll drop all those links in the video's description. But the youngest of children can help me count how many frogs are on the log. So they're counting with me, and then as each frog hops into the water, we're counting them again. So this is one of the many reasons why I love to use props during circle time. And for older children, you can use dice. You can roll the dice, they can count the dots on top, and then whatever you have, they get that many. Our 4 and 5 year olds especially love to use these. And of course, there are so many books. There are fun characters that are involve counting. And then just like using props, there are books that are children's favorites, like Five Little Monkeys Jumping on the Bed. I can't even tell you how many times I have read this book and we have sung this song. Five Little Monkeys Swinging from the Tree. Just any kind of book that involves counting, the children love it. And while I am talking about circle time, I wanted to also show you that we have quite a few packs in at Teachers Pay Teachers that involve counting. So for example, this is for coming up for the fall. These are apple counting cards, and this is part of our apple packet. In our toddler winter props packet, we have lots of counting. These are props that you can use for so many different things for circle time. In our song and rhymes packet, volume 2, we have this apple tree counting activity where you have the tree and then the children help you count while you're singing this song.
I shook that tree as hard as it could, and down came the apple. It was good. Rub your tummy. It was good. Yes.
And because we love Five Little Monkeys Jumping on a Bed so much, we put together a packet over on Teachers Pay Teachers called Five Little Friends Jumping on a Bed. And there are different characters depending on the season or the holiday. And then they have a bed with a matching little bedspread depending on who they are. In this case, these are little squirrels. So five little squirrels jumping on a bed. And their bedspread has little acorns on it. But this is a fun packet because, as I said, especially 2 and young 3 year olds, they love the Five Little Monkeys. So I just love to take it a little farther and change the characters that are jumping on the bed.
And bumped her head. Mommy called the doctor, and the doctor said,
what did he say?
No more Valentine bears jumping on the bed.
And then another packet that we have on Teachers Pay Teachers, and this is not necessarily just for circle time, although you could use these at circle time, but this is also a great table activity. And you have different numbers, and then there are dots. And you can use these with dot markers, you can use these with circle stickers, but another thing I've just had them do is I've given them each a different number, and they've done watercolor with them, and I've cut them out. They're on heavier paper, and we hang these in the classroom from 1 to 10. So it is a number line, but it's one that they helped me create. And talking about classroom displays, if you have number posters. You could have these in your room as well. I have a 1 to 10. They're little cards that we have in numerical order that are close to our circle time area. And I'll often walk over and we'll count 1 to 10 using that. So there really are a lot of different ways. Again, just like my other videos, this just barely taps on all the different ways that you can work on counting skills. I mean, even things like when we stand in line and we're ready to go to circle, I will count all their heads. Now I'm doing that because I'm making sure I have all the children, but this is also great for the children because they're helping me count as I tap each head. Or during circle time, I'll walk around and tap each head of each child, and then they help me. We're all counting together. And of course, music is another place where there is lots of counting. In fact, if you go to my Spotify playlist, and I'll drop a link to that in this video's description, within each month, there's always some counting songs in there. So they could either be evergreen, meaning you can sing them all year round, or they could be holiday, seasonal related. I love to add counting any way we can. So make sure to let me know in the comments how you add counting to your day, because we would all love to hear that. Please subscribe to Teaching 2 and 3-Year-Olds on YouTube. Press that bell icon so that every time I publish a new video, you'll be notified. Thanks for watching.